Hi there. In this video, I'm going to show you how to replace all of this with that little thing. That's actually even smaller because it's still in its box. As many of my subscribers already know, this is the old laptop that I'm using, IBM X41, and a cloned VCDS interface, and this laptop works directly at 12 volts, so I was a bit lucky and I didn't need a power brick. But still, I needed to carry this thing around in my car always, because I always like to have my diagnostics close to me. And somebody could see that I have a laptop in the car, and they could actually break into my car for the cheapest and oldest possible laptop, but they wouldn't know that until they break into my car. So yeah, and it's a lot to carry around all the time, obviously. This is why I reached out to OBDeleven if they want to send a unit to be used in all my future modification and diagnostics video, and they agreed to it. So here is the unit. It's a ProPack. ProPack, I don't know why I said it that weirdly. Okay, so let's get this thing out of the way. It will be no longer required. Okay, so let's get to the unboxing. As you can see, we have a manual in here, which is quite interesting, so tiny. Put that aside. And the unit itself. And I always wondered why you would need to have it on something like this, a keychain ring. And then I realized that it actually makes it easier to pull out, so you can pull on this thing and get it out from your connector. Or something else, you could attach to this one of those, I'm not sure how they are called, neck straps, those white materials that you put around your neck. So if you are a technician using this thing, there is a way smaller chance that you forget it in one of the cars that you are working on, because it has that huge and probably colorful neck strap on it. So there's that. So this actually does make sense. Anyway, this comes in more than one model. There is a standard, I think I would call it basic one, where you can check your engine codes and stuff like that. But it does not allow you to do everything that I was previously doing with my VCDS, like long coding and stuff like that. So I would highly... Yeah, if you just want to check your engine errors and reset service interval and check your battery status and stuff like that, the standard version is more than enough for you. But if you are like me and want to go deeper into the controllers and change the coding and other things, then the Pro version is the one to go. And you might see that these things also come with something called credits. You do not need the credits if you do all the coding by yourself. You use the credits when you are using the built-in apps from the application on the phone, because you are controlling this thing with your mobile phone. So you need this and your mobile phone. Android or iOS works on any of them. Yeah, so only when using those apps, which are somehow automatic things that, for example, turn on your daytime running lights, for example. Then using one of those apps, it will subtract from your credits. If you do it manually and go into long coding in the modules and whatever, it's not using credits. So there's that with credits. If you like automated stuff, you buy the credits. If not, you can do it yourself. So don't think it's something that you will continue to need to buy and invest money into the future. Anyway, another thing, this requires internet to work, and it somehow even ties in with automatic Google searches when it finds some errors. So it gives you more information about that error if you want to do it like that and make it search a bit faster than you would by yourself, insert the error code in Google and stuff like that. So yeah, let's plug this in, install the app on my phone. I think I will also need to insert the pro code probably into the app, and there's that. Anyway, these things work on as many cars as you need, so it's not something that ties into your car and you cannot use it on something else. So yep, let's continue. Okay, so at the moment I just connected it to the device and it's updating, so we will let it finish and obviously follow the on-screen instructions on my phone. And it finished. So okay, yep, I need to create a password, so be back. And it has automatically recognized my email, so I have 200 credits and the pro version obviously. And it's recognizing my car, which is correct. I don't even think I would need to do this. Okay. Probably it was enough that it recognized it by itself. Okay, so I clicked on OK there, and then I clicked on scan, which was exactly in the middle of the screen where it says scanning now, but my recording stopped because my wife called me. Yeah. Nothing that you can do. So I will wait for the scan to complete and see what this thing reports, and then be back to you. And the scan is complete. I don't want to clear faults for the moment, so I will not hold it hold in the middle of this thing my finger. Let's go to this button and see the errors. Gateway has some error. Radio, yeah, for radio I was expecting, I think it's something related to a speaker. Let's see, faults. Yep, left front bass speaker, open circuit. Yeah, I know about that, I need to fix that. I changed the wiring a bit and somehow one of the speakers, it's still working, but it gives me that error, so we'll see about that someday. So I clicked on in the right hand upper corner, you can see an envelope in there, and it's generating a log, and I think it will actually send it directly to my email when it finishes, which is absolutely perfect. Let me quickly show you how you can actually use that Google to search. Let's see for this one, for faults key one. Let's see how we Google it. And as you can see, you directly have the A4 and trouble code, and it's giving you the Google results, and you can obviously go further and see what other people had to say about this. Okay, so at this point let's go into the menu, into the car, and then let me show you the so-called apps. As you can see, these are the things that you can actually buy with credits. So they are some kind of one-click activations for various things that your car model supports. It's the easy version of long coding. You cannot actually go wrong with it. You click it, they subtract your required credits. As you can see, not all of them have the same number of credits required to activate, so they subtract you the number of credits, do automatically everything,
and basically you're done. You don't need to know anything about car coding. You can do a lot of things yourself. Yeah, others pay a lot of money to have stuff like this activated. Now let's get back and see the gauges. These things can help you, troubleshoot things. Here I was checking the interior temperature, the AC temperature and pressure in this case, for example. Or some of them, maybe you just want to look at something when you are driving. Like this fuel level, if you are some kind of freak and want to know exactly how much fuel your car is consuming. And yeah, there are a lot of them. I don't think, yeah, you can see here the temperature of the catalytic converter, sorry about that. So there's that. A lot of these gauges that you can actually activate and get quite useful informations from them. I used something similar to this a while back, a few good years back, to actually troubleshoot a problem with the turbo on my Octavia that I was having at that particular moment, and it saved me a lot of money. So there's that. If you go into control units, you see directly each and every unit, and you can go in detail into one of them, so you can see the units even without doing a scan like I did at the beginning of the video. You can go directly into one of the units if you have something that you want to do in there. For example, here in gateway, you can go to I'm not even sure exactly. Yeah, so in a channel here I can actually get the information in gateway from my battery, for example, channel 19 in this case, or 18 was it? Anyway, something like that. And it gives me the voltage, how much current I'm putting into the battery at this very moment, its temperature, and you can see two small blue arrows at the bottom of the screen. From those you can increase or decrease the channel number to see other informations. And you can see here in the description, it actually gives you more info about the data that you are looking at. And yes, it's not for everything, just for some of the data that you are seeing, it has more info. It does help sometimes. Yeah, here is about your battery aging and stuff like that. And just want to tell you, never work on the car for days on end without starting the motor and charging your battery, because I almost destroyed a new battery. So yeah, take that from me. If you work a lot on your car, put a battery charger on the battery and work on it like that, or maybe disconnect it, or start your engine and drive a little bit around, or something like that, because otherwise you can have problems. Yeah, so there's that. That is what I'm checking at this point. Okay, long coding, it's exactly like it was in the VCDS tool. You can check and uncheck bits, in particular bytes. So you can do any coding that you find online on any website, exactly like you do it in VCDS. You can also do it from OBDeleven without any issue, so you are not missing out on absolutely anything. And as VCDS does, it actually gives you information on some of the possible coding in here, but not on all of them. None of these softwares actually give you info on all of the possible coding. So for me, this was quite a relief when I saw that I can actually do basic, advanced coding like I was doing before. So that's quite awesome. And yeah, you can hear my baby girl in the background maybe. She's trying her voice. So in the end, this is a complete tool. I was afraid of missing out on anything that my VCDS was able to do. I'm not missing out. OBDeleven can do everything that I was doing before and do it with a tiny stick that you plug directly into the car without wires or anything, just through Bluetooth from your mobile phone. So much less complicated, with an easier and more intuitive interface, a lot easier to use by people that don't know as much about these softwares, and detailed enough for people that do know a lot about these softwares, and it even tells you to not forget the device in your car. So that's attention to details, honestly. So I'm quite happy that I made this switch in the end, and thank you very much, OBDeleven, for providing this tool to me, and it will be used for sure in future videos. So thank you again, and bye.